Okay, so here's an example of time value of money. Consider the value x is equal to 5,306 rand on the timeline below. Okay, there we see there's x, 5,306 rand at year 7. Let y be this value of x at time t. So there's time t, okay, and that's the value y, and it's the same value but at a different time period. Okay, so what is the value of y if interest was calculated at 5% per annum compounded every year? And this time we notice, okay, so here's our value for x. We need to go backwards. What do we call that again? Discounting. We are discounting with 1, 2, 3, 4 years. So we're going to use this formula. Y is equal to x 1 plus y to the power of n. And the only thing that we should remember is because I'm going backwards on my number line, this n is going to take a negative value. So do we know y? No, y is still unknown. Do we know the value of x? Actually, we do. It's 5,306. Do we know the value of I, the interest? We are working in years. It wasn't specified, so we'll use the yearly rate of 5% means divide by 100. And now n, very careful, n is now 1, 2, 3, 4 times that interest was added. But because I'm going backwards, I am doing negative 4. I am discounting. And now if I substitute all of this into my formula, I get 5,306 times 1 plus 0,05 to the power of negative 4. And if we work that out, 5,306 times in a bracket 1.05 when it's added to the power of 4, but with a negative. Okay, it's negative 4, gives me 4,365.26. Gives me 4,365.25. There we go. That would be the value at time t. And just very important to note, do you notice how these two values, the past value is less than the future value, which makes sense because the future value included more interest. Okay, in the next video, we'll look at an example that is a slight bit more complicated than this, but it comes down to the same idea. See you then.